Once you've figured out how to initiate your row with your shoulder, and you're putting the shoulder blade in the right position to have enough mobility to do your row efficiently, then we need to pick the right amount of ROM, range of motion. We need to choose how far we actually want our arm to move. And it's not this case that I just do it as much as I can and that's the best outcome, because what happens when I force the motion is I have to compromise the integrity of some of the joints involved. So as I do my row, even if I pull my shoulder blade back, it can only go so far, right? And if I keep kind of driving my elbow back, eventually my shoulder joint runs out of real estate and I have to find that motion some other way. What you'll notice is that the shoulder joint then pokes out forward. We call this an anterior humeral glide. The joint of the shoulder actually starts sliding forward anteriorly. And that removes some of the surface area congruence in that joint. So I have decreased stability. I start to move around on the glenoid labrum, that soft tissue that you hear baseball players injure all the time. And I'm compromising the structural integrity of what's going on. So in this case, if I'm doing this, I am rowing too far. I am picking a range of motion that is too far. Now I want to optimize range of motion so that when I'm putting my strength on and I'm putting my muscle on, I'm still maintaining this ability to be flexible. Right? Flexibility, dynamic mobility. These things are important for keeping our bodies healthy, but too much is too much. Okay. And that's just our general rule. So what I'm looking for usually in a row is as I lead with my shoulder blade, if I'm doing everything else really well, I've got my spine stabilized, my rib cage doesn't look too asymmetrical, my head is set back, and I lead with my shoulder blade, then I'm gonna go until the elbow joint clears the back, the upper back, the back line that is being made. And once I clear that, then I'm feeling that upper back muscle turn on. I might even feel some lat pulling that weight. Hopefully I'm feeling that because that's my prime mover during this exercise. And then once I get there, I can just stop for a second, kill the momentum, and return back to the starting position.